Stories. Edward and his father Henry were descendants of William the Conqueror, the Norman Duke who invaded England in 1066. Edward and Henry were two powerful men, but two very different rulers. Henry was just 9 years old when he became king. He inherited a kingdom in crisis. The country was at war. Many lords, or barons as they were known, were in rebellion over high taxes and royal demands. Rebellion continued into Henry's reign, and he struggled to keep control. He took refuge here at the Tower during periods of unrest and civil war. Despite this, Henry managed to hold on to power and reigned for 56 years, longer than any other medieval king of England. He loved art and architecture, and was very religious. He rebuilt Westminster Abbey into the magnificent church that stands today. Henry married Eleanor of Provence, and they enjoyed a long and happy life together. When Henry died, their firstborn son, Edward, inherited the throne. Was a very different type of king. He was tall and muscular, an advantage in war as his arms were very much of his sword.
Check this. Thank you. Thank you. standard of living, the food and other amenities which we firmly treat as a town, but they amuse visitors even around the world.
Thank you. Is page 10, you will notice that there is some examples of graffiti. This is from people who were imprisoned by Henry VIII in the aftermath of a particular event. And I would like you to see what, how many of these pieces of graffiti you can find. And also, feel free to use your phones to find out who these people are and what event they connect to. We haven't got long, so go and find things.
Thank you. Thank you. if you've done it, if you knew that.
I can't remember it. So, so you ran up and run that in here. What do you want to say? You can say.
Sorry.
Ah, curva, I got dizzy, man. Okay, sorted.
Good. Managed it.
Yeah, thank you.
Just the right time. Always makes me laugh when you see not only on the top floor, and I see a tall gentleman, and they've got their children on there. Yeah, there's a child that's going to get the smack on that head. I've toyed with the idea of buying one of these myself.
Oh, you should buy.
Yeah?
You should, if you like to take videos or whatever.
Yeah.
You should buy one. Makes it easy.
Makes it easy, yeah.
Yeah. It's not going to be shaky or something.
So there's two types of artillery down here. Mortar.
Mortar.
And so a mortar, you fill it with gunpowder.
Okay.
Around 30 pounds. And then you use an iron shower. You can see these ones. You can see them better on the video.
Oh, may I?
Can you see it's full in a hole?
Yeah.
So this is where you put something like 10 pounds of gunpowder.
Yeah,
can you see these lugs here?
Mm-hmm.
So if I have a metal metal pole with a metal chain,
okay,
I can
hook
in, attach it to there, and now three or four people, because that's 23 pounds of iron.
Yeah.
So you're going to take about two or three men to move it and lower it into your mortar.
Okay.
And then each of them has a fuse. So then when you ignite the fuse and you work to the right length, this is going to fire.
This is huge.
It's going to fire it high up into the air, and gravity is going to take it to its target. So you can go A high, which is really good if you're trying to take out a defensive position on a cliff top, because you can have a shallow boat.
Yeah, yeah.
With these, called a bomb vessel, and you can take out something that's high up.
It's good.
Whereas,
because I never saw this kind of
mortars.
Yeah, I never saw them.
Most of these are French, so a British fleet have gone in with soldiers and captured places like Calais.
Yeah.
And then you either left these behind, blew these up, or you brought them back. Remember, they're very expensive. Only kings, very wealthy people can afford
them.
These. A cannon, different piece of artillery. Cannon means tube. This is my tube.
Yeah, this everyone look. So everyone knows about this, but I never saw this.
But did you know that the earliest people making cannons are bell foundries? This is a bell.
Oh, really?
A bell with a tube.
With a tube. Okay.
And then, because you've got lots of money, you personalize it. And so you put your
logo, shield, your shield, your...
your Latin motto and various decorations. This is a Chinese dragon. These are stylized Chinese dolphins.
Mm-hmm.
Mermaids. Yeah. On the top floor, you would have seen about where there was a fire here in the Tower of London in 1841.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And all these objects melted. Were in the building directly opposite. And so the temperatures reached over 1,000 degrees. So that's what melts bronze. And you'll notice there's only one carriage because they're made of wood. So mm-hmm. the wood is destroyed but leaves behind the metal.
Mm-hmm. Incredible.
This is one of the largest cannon. And this is from Henry VIII. And you can see the Tudor rose just here.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, sir.
How you doing, guys? You all right?
Hello, yes.
So this is the oldest working door in England.
Is it?
Yeah.
That's not.
And so it's a door that's been reused. And if I just show you, hold it there. You see the interior. This is 13th century.
Wow.
And then they wanted to reuse this door, so they've added extra planks at the bottom, and then put planks on top of it. On either side, and this all this metal here, 17th century. Imagine what that door is seeing.
Is that a 17th-year-old door?
So we lock this door. The hinges and the metal work is all very big to hold these.
Maybe you come through here.
Do you want to come to this space?
It goes down. I get to them. I get to them.